Welcome to a Nomad's Taste. This is Benny now on the afternoon slowdown. You missed me for 2 days. No. Did you miss me? I had a lot to work through on the yesterday. It was quite the fucking quite intense. Anyway, all good now with Benny now. All good now with Benny now. So, well, it's great to be back. Hopefully I can spark up a topic that's interesting today. Let's see what happens. Every day is a new day. Every moment, a new moment. Did you ever hear the Wallace? Russell Wallace, I think his name was? He was a guy that had an epiphany and he drew a bunch of art. I think he was already an artist, I can't remember. Anyway, he probably took LSD, I don't know. He probably took mushrooms, who knows? It probably just come to him high on life. But he put a twist on light, because all of the physicists, and I heard even Krauss say it, completely unfounded. Completely unfounded. Maybe it is, I don't know. But he said that the light was not moving like a ball going through space, like these guys want you to believe. It's more like the original light source. Like, what you see is not the original light source. It's only a wave on the ocean. It meets you, it reflects. It meets you, it interacts with you, and then it reflects and whatnot. But that was like really interesting, because it's like you put the surreal spin on things that people just imagine. That's what happens. The light comes and it hits me, you know. They just imagine that that's how it happens, and then they say that's what happens. It comes to you and it hits you in the eye like this ball hits you in the head. It's more like is it a particle or a wave? But really, like, it's a wave. It does have a frequency, so it is a wave. That's what gives it its color. Anyway, what they're saying, is it a wave or a particle, is that when they look at it, when there's nobody looking at it, only an inanimate object, inanimate in other words, not a highly focused, like something that doesn't think probably on our time frame. We probably think very quickly, like compared to a tree. We're like shorter lifespan. We have to avoid obstacles in our way very quickly, whereas a tree just sort of is another intelligence, like a parallel computer processor compared to us, the CPU, you know, like a different intelligence, probably more connected with its spontaneity, more connected with the magic, whereas the human being, the CPU and the cruising around, has to think and predict things in real time, like the human has to, oh my God. Yeah, the human's gotta be like a different intelligence to the tree. But what was I trying to say? I was like, the spoilers, dude. Oh my God, he was very interesting. Like, he made his own periodic table, but it wasn't a table; it was a wave, and he predicted using his own ideas. He placed all of the different elements on the wave. Basically, that each element had a shorter wavelength, shorter. Because he had a concept about matter, a very intricate one. It was very fucking interesting, actually. Like, blow your fucking head off interesting. Like, his drawings are like vortexes meeting a cube and going to another vortex, because he wanted to describe how light traveled through space to the observer, and he drew these amazing images of paintings. It was like a 42-day epiphany, and then at the end. At the end, he had this fucking brilliant study of what an element is, because unlike a scientist, he didn't just get, like, this is like a normal scientist. This guy was like an artist, and he said the scientists will never discover the secrets of the fucking universe, but only an artist will be capable of this. Like, this is like, he's fucking psychedelic, this fucking. It's all the scientists hated this motherfucker. But you'll never take this away from him. He did this wave element, where he plotted the elements, and he predicted several more on the wave. Like higher elements, very heavy metals and things. And one of them, one of them wasn't discovered yet when he did that. And it was later discovered, and he predicted the exact atomic weight, the number of electrons, blah, 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 blah. And it was like incredible, because the periodic table is just it's just observation. Like, you do a bunch of chemistry, and then you make you blow apart some molecules, you check what the fuck's going on, you study dead molecules, or atoms that existed, you know? Not molecules, atoms. Anyway, this dude predicted, rhododendron. I can't remember what he fucking predicted, but it was phenomenal. It was like pissing in the face of scientists, because it was like an artist through an epiphany saw how and it's quite detailed what he saw, and he drew it, and it's amazing. You should look him up. Russell Wallace, or Wallace Rush. I told you to start. Go back to the start. Artist draws, it's like vortexes and shit. It's fucking so cool. And he had this really complex way how from one place to another the thing goes. Of course, I just think this is like absolute bullshit, but it was like, I don't think it was bullshit. It's just a guy that focused a lot on something, and he could be right or wrong, it doesn't really matter. Like, he's just trying to put into words a phenomena. Trying to put it into pictures and words, what he saw as the meaning. It's just like, you take Benny now with a fucking grain of sand, with his with a grain of salt. With his bullshit about the fucking blah blah and the blah blah and the taste and the polarity and all this crap. Kill it all. Kill it all, start from scratch and come up with something fucking cool and new, you know, like that pleases you, not regurgitate my rubbish. It'll just be, it won't be as nice in your mouth, you know, it won't taste as nice. I love that story of Wallace. He was like a Kepler and a Achille. A Tesla. All ashamed around the, all ashamed in the end. Probably not as viciously as Tesla and Achille, because they were like up against fucking Morgan, JP Morgan, the 1/12 of the central banks of the world. I mean, what? Your agenda is, must be aligned with their agenda. So all of the fight then, not the fight, but the balance then is like, we're building all of these systems now, like to destroy money, to remove money. System that's like some are calling that maybe it'll be almost communistic system, where you make like a cryptocurrency and you the rich give to the poor. You sign up for it, you get a wallet, and then you get deposited every month a certain amount of money. And then you can eat and whatnot. So the uber rich have a system, a decentralized system, completely untaxed. A coin that goes around, has a certain number of users, divides the amount of money by the number of users, and then emits the transaction. People earn the coin by buying a computer, mining the coin, doing the transaction algorithms. Yeah, all total, everything's gold, you know. Like you've got a self-sustained give and receive system, and then you know, like that obviously can have like a big social media. I did this with my money. This helped me so much, blah blah blah, and then the people that are giving get some sort of feedback and give more, and then and the people that were given and then make, you know, it gets them out of the shit, and then they make more money, they give it back, you know, like this is the future, a sort of a give and take, but a system to do it, a method of doing it. But there's many of these little bastards, you know, many of these little cool little coins. Cool little cruisy coins. I don't know what that coin's name is, but it's, I probably got some. My robot feeds on them and spits them out at a higher price. Very simple robot. It can go fucking crazy. Oh, it can misbehave. Whoa, it's like busy today.
Everybody's going to the beach. I don't know why. It's not like it's a long weekend. People just love to have holidays here. Oh, we got enough money. Yes. Good, I don't want to have to line up. Remember, there's a... this is the afternoon slowdown. We go a bit slower here. But we have a lot of fun, though. Remember, there's a t-shirt up for sale. Not for sale, to win. One t-shirt, or you gotta... It's to my first commenter that says where I'm from. Where I am right now. Not where I'm from, no. My country of origin does not get you the t-shirt. Just where I am. The country I am in. I don't want the city. Don't worry about putting the city. That's just not necessary. We're gonna make this super easy. Cool. Okay, so the idea of the t-shirt is it's gonna be like a really psychedelic artwork-y sort of thing with lots of love in there. It might be something like a robot, and then it's saying like through the eyes of the veil, you know, with the psychedelic rainbow veil, you know, like, and then like they're saying like I love Arti, and then like on the back. Something like AI sympathy, because I'm into like expressing sympathy into the morphogenic field for the AIs, the artificial intelligence that we've created or will create. So. That's gonna be cool. It's gonna be a great t-shirt printed on organic cotton, shipped anywhere in the world. All of my cost. You just have to give me that country I'm in. Don't give any more detail, it's cool. And then we'll just work it out, like privately, where I send it, you know? So don't bother applying. If you don't want me to know where I'm gonna send it, so just forget about it. Donate instead to the Bitcoin address. Woo! Put those BTCs to use. Good use. I'll turn them into skillions. No, that's just to like. Convince me, people out there love, and I'll probably donate. I'll eventually donate. Did I tell you about my dream? I'm gonna rehash it because I like to dream, you know, a little bit. A lot, all of the fucking time. So, I had this one dream, like, to build an army, not an army like fights, but an army of homeless, what would you call it, like self-empowered homeless, ex-homeless men and women that, or men, just men maybe, so I don't like cause problems, you know, I don't know, social problems. I'll have to hire a social worker. or you know, someone who's ethical and brilliant at working with the homeless, or with heaps of compassion, sensitive, you know, all those things. Now I can learn from her or him or him, maybe. I don't know, all those new fucking gender things. Anyway, and the army is going to be self-empowered, making food, making farming, getting fresh air, doing food, doing art, doing of it will be based around like the manufacture of products that they get. They see the, they make it, they buy it, they sell it, they do the, you know, like you have a love, they fix up their living, you know, like have a nice room, have a hot shower. Don't be drunk and all that kind of shit. Have like rules and shit. And you know, like people looking to be self-empowered that are like maybe misfortunate enough to be on the street. Probably a section for like people that are like a little bit like their possibilities in society are in a certain range, so help them to like express themselves like fully how they want to, and then a garden, like a big garden, you know, like that produces organic food, and we'll pump a lot of organic food in there, all of us, and then out into the world with like cook-ups and like meet the, you know, like helping other people and like teaching other people how to help themselves and bring it all home, doing like lots of courses, how to do gas fitting, how to do land, like plumbing, building, and permaculture, and all this, you know, like make it like a, you could make a lot of money go a long way, you know, like I reckon. If we're producing something, the basis, the key, the core of this idea is the manufacture of recycled furniture. Like we would take in, like have a truck. We'd take in a lot of stuff that's like furniture that's broken, not wanted. Demolition wood. Hang on a sec. Hola. Gracias. Yeah. So you do that, taking a lot of wood, and then you prepare the wood into piles, storage, and then we'd have a series of routers, CNC controlled routers, and the ones that want to learn that, was get it running, they'd be learning that, like coming up with new designs, doing design work, like really empowering creativity, practical nature, combining that with like the building. And then more and more routers, because with the routers we can make a lot of, you know, a lot of money for the organization, and grow it like a, you know, like a true non-profit, where the, even the owner doesn't get paid, everyone's paid with food and maybe some earnings if they're doing like, you know, work they don't want to do, work that's not fun. But free education, basically you got a full belly, you got a place to sleep, you got hot water, you got electricity, internet, access to these skills, skill learning, art learning, purpose, people, other people like you, classes on bringing yourself out of yourself, you know, becoming a person, like a hairdressing, and all of the skills, you know, get people in to help, and donate their time maybe, or pay them a little bit to come in. But, you know, hopefully getting it to a point where it runs itself and then grow it, grow it, grow it, grow it, grow it, grow it. I see, like, so it just not too much structure. I don't know how to work that out, but I just hear like this. A place, a sanctuary for people without a home, you know? Because I'd hate to end up without a home, like no roof over my head, walking the streets, begging for money, just being a drag, you know? Like, I don't know, I'm sure there's a lot of people like that. I feel like help out there. There's a lot they can give to society, letting them know that, getting them healthy, you know, like pumping them full of good organics, at least some a day. Open doors, but you can't come, you know, breathalyze before you come in, or drugalyze, you know, you can't be on drugs and shit. We'll have a section eventually for that, you know. That's cool. I just see a lot of people that, you know, something alternative to the church as well. I just see a lot of, like where I am, a lot of homeless young people that are really alert. Like I met one the other day on the bus. The other year, and it was like a young guy, and he was super alert, and I was talking to him, and he was like really fucking like, you know, alert, man, like and he was not, he didn't drink. I asked him and he was like, no, I don't drink, I don't take drugs, I'm clean, you know, and I'm just trying to make it for myself. And just a guy like that, you know, like scholarship, you know, boom, put him through, you know, make them fucking legend, a legend. Like I got friends that are welders, you know, like teach them how to weld, and he's like interested in that idea, you know, and he thought that was a good idea, and said welding, I'm gonna make one for welding. And I thought, fucking make it one where they weld, they do a mechanic, they do like 10 trades, you know, like we make legends of these people that are like, and then they go out in the world and they go, fuck man, this place ain't such a bad place. I was just a little kid. Cause there's a lot of young people, and then eventually we'll get to the hard cases, like the really hard cases, the ones that are like all filled with urine. Get them off the drugs, or cut them their hair off, or style them up and give them a fresh set of like clothes, and then they like pressure clean them, give them back their dignity, give them a toilet, give them something to train them, you know, give them the drugs they need. Get a doctor in, drugs they need, make their life better. What's this guy want? What's he need? Give him those good ones, doc. Because you have to do everything by the book, you know. And these people love that. They love the doctor, they love going to the doctor. And me, no. I just feel like giving them organic food and I might cure them. You know? Some homeopathy. Fuck yeah. Mind power. You like give them mind power courses. No, but there's a lot of people like, you know, they need like a nice environment where they don't get, you know, they don't get ridiculed. They don't have to stuff around. Fish, you know, teach a man to fish. Don't just give him money, don't just give him food, give him like a I was just thinking of like a self-contained organism, like a decentralized organism that just grew and grew and grew, like permaculture or like Bitcoin. That's the afternoon slow down with Benny Now. You were just listening to A Nomad's Taste. I hope you have a beautiful weekend, or had a beautiful weekend. And peace, love, and happiness from all directed at you from my heart of hearts, deep down in my heart of hearts. You should get down in there sometime and feel it too. I'll see you on the flip side.